Thank you. About the class of completely integrable evolutionary models. In the beginning, I would like to say a few words about Pan Julian. The first time when I was invited to Bendeleva, it was 2004. Before this time, I have never been in Bendeleva, and this was my nice discovering of this place. Special friendly and soft view on all participants of the conference, nice environment, nice place, nice spirit of the Bendeleva. All of them left in my memory, and I very thank you for Pan Julian for invitation, and keep the contacts long time after that, during the Bendeleva conference at all. The basic ideas of this presentation appeared in Bendeleva. I would like to talk about one class of completely integrable evolutionary models. known and previously unknown analytical solution of evolutionary equations expressed in the term of Euler beta function are presented. It is shown that in some cases it is possible to obtain an analytical solution for the harvesting in evolutionary equation. The using of non-power law generating function allows us to propose the previously unused evolutionary models, which are also completely integrable. The obtained results can be applied in ecology, physics, chemistry, and medicine. Really, I would like to present three different parts of my presentation. The first part devoted to the weakly non-local supersymmetric Cadivic hierarchy. The second one, a variety of the population models. I would like, in this section, I would like to show that even simplest models like Malthusian's growth or exponential function could be modified and applied to the experimental data also. Some analytical solution of evolutionary equation expressed in terms of Euler beta function. This is a third part of this presentation. In contrast to the usual history of science, we know exactly the day and time when the nonlinear science was both. For instance, a linear linear theory of the linear evolution, linear wave, is unknown. We can start from the D'Alembert papers, maybe earlier, but we don't know exactly the date of birth. But in soliton science, we know this data exactly. It was in August 1834 when John Scott Russell describes the observed, first of all, observed and then describe the observation of unique solitary wave. This is a famous history. The theoretical background was a little bit later in 1895, when Dédéric Cortevez and Gustave de Vries represent his famous Cortevez-de Vries equation. I think this would be nice to remind you short derivation, KDV. From the beginning, we can start from the linear wave equation like this, which unify two separate waves, which moves in different directions with constant velocity c. For the left waves, we can simplify equation like this, and for the right waves, like this. The flat waves has the dispersion relation when omega equals to ck, k is wave number, and to for the initial wave equation, we have dispersion relation like this. This is very trivial, very simple, and well known. In general case, omega square depends on the wave number square through the unknown function phi. For small k, we can expand this area with respect to the k and restrict ourselves by the first two terms. First two terms, k in power 1 and k in power 3. Using the deep relation between dispersion relation and differential operators, we can immediately obtain the linear version of the KDV. This looks like this star equation. And the last step to obtain KDV, we have to change the, we can to admit that velocity is not constant. Velocity could be depend on the field function phi. In this case, we just obtain the in the case of right waves, we can obtain the Burgers equation. In the case of KDV, we can obtain the equation like this, and change the reference frame to the moving with constant velocity c, we obtain the classical KDV equation. The importance of this derivation, you know, this doesn't depend on hydrodynamic at all, because after now we know that KDV appears in very very different sciences, not only in hydrodynamics and also in plasma physics and crystal physics and so on and so on. And initial derivation of this equation by Kortweck and De Vries not has universal character. This derivation is just doesn't depend on concrete field of science. Now about non-local supersymmetric KDVK hierarchy. A few words in general. I think, I'm sure that this is a unification. Three different stories: non-linearity, non-locality, and supersymmetry. Cross-section of these three fields of generalizations of evolutionary equations belongs to the nonlinear, nonlocal, supersymmetric KDVK hierarchy, which I would like to propose. History, really, we have a lot of attempts to generalize KDV in nonlocal wave and apply KDV to the special sciences, not only in hydrodynamic field. And I think the best is to separate all attempts in three different groups. The first group of non-local KDV generalization, when we considering a small perturbation of non-local case just to the classical KDV plus some new term, which depends on the field function phi and its space derivative. Non-locality means that evolutionary equation and all field function and its derivative depends not only on the same space and time point, but at least one point of the neighbors of this this point of consideration. The second group is just the possibility to change the third term with the third space derivative and substitute or maybe modificate this term in by the non-local operator. Really, this is this group of possible generalization is overlapped by the Witham equation. Some time ago, Witham proposed for the linear case generalization like this, when K is an integral transform of such time, phi hat means Fourier transform of function phi. To obtain, if we would like to obtain the classical KDV in this approach, we have to choose the kernel K on P like this one, and we obtain the classical KDV. One of the there is just a few examples. Papers Nakoryakov and Schreiber, Kobelev, Ostrovsky was introduced the equation like this one with additional term of the field function phi and the integral term like this. The next one is Kakutani Matsuuchi, like this one, VP Varol principle of the this integral transform. By the way, this equation also could be obtained from the Witham equation when K on P equals to this one. Ostrovsky and Ott Sudan proposed some time ago the equation like this. This depends on optical phenomena when light light phenomena in optical crystals. And one more generalization, in this case, the in integral kernel looks like this. Okay, I would like to introduce the as I mentioned, not only non-local, but also and supersymmetric and not for one equation, but for a lot of them. There is one more possibility to introduce the non-locality to use so-called fractional derivatives. The history is old and interesting. The first paper about fractional derivatives belongs to the correspondence between Newton and between Leibniz and Liouville. They discussed about possibility to generalize the differential operator on the non-integer case. Much more later, Marchaux proposed the so-called Marchaux fractional derivative, which looks like this. The essential point is that we can consider the fractional differential operator in the form when the usual integer space derivative is a fractional power fractional derivative is a fractional power of usual space derivative. It's possible to introduce the non-local differential operator in this way, but the one important aspect that this approach, this derivative doesn't have inverse one. That is why for application usually use the Riemann-Liouville or Caputo fractional derivatives. The best way is monograph is to look at the monograph Samko-Kilbas-Marichev, despite on the quite old issue of this monograph. This is, from my point of view, this is the best monograph in this area, despite that during the last 3 years, a lot of monographs on the fractional calculation appears in the internet and the book shops. Super transformations. Let's consider two kinds of fields. Phi is usual, a scalar field which depends on x and time variables, and psi is a fermionic one, like Spinorian, spinor field. We can consider the transformation like this. When p equal to zero, we can usual super transformation, which appears from supersymmetry, theory of supersymmetry. But here I would like to propose the fractional generalization, commutation of these two transformation again arrives to the classical spatial derivative of integer power, despite that here we have the fractional one. And now first result of this first part is a supersymmetric equation like this. He is unification of two functions. Yes, here. He is unification of two functions, phi and psi. Theta is constant spinor. And d is a fractional derivative in Caputo sense. Okay. T in this is T derivative respect T and X derivative respect to space variable X. In component, this is a simple supersymmetric notation. In the component form, this equation equals to the system of two separate but dependence on each other equations, I mean system five, when supersymmetric spinor function psi depends not only psi but and on field function phi, and time derivative of phi depends not only on phi but only on psi two. This system in this equation is invariant, and the super transformation by the equation two, and it's can be checked by the direct calculation. Now detailized this system in respect to the fractional power pi. Pi is not integer. When the pi equals to zero, we obtain the system of two equation like this. And when pi equals to one, we have equation system equation like this. When pi equals to one, this system was considered by Manin and Radul many years ago, but according to this approach, we can consider not only pi equal one and not only pi equal zero, but any pi from zero to one. In other words, we can consider the fractional generalization of KdV, super KdV equation. Physical constants, contents. The supersymmetric equation proposed in corresponding system unites two fields of different nature, and only one of them is non-local. At the parameter of fractional derivative, the supersymmetric equation turns into ordinary supersymmetric equation, which allows us to call equation as non-local supersymmetric KdV equation, abbreviation NSKdV, non-local supersymmetric KdV equation. Classical KdV possess a lot of conservation laws. It's possible to check that the super non-local KdV also possess an infinite number of conservation laws. First of all, it has a Lax representation like this one. This is a commutator. This is differential operator, but D, in contrast to the classical Lax pair and classical KdV, has non-local nature. Corresponding conservation laws we can calculate from the equation 9. The first conservation law is trivial because according to the bordering condition on the plus minus infinity equals to zero, but the second one is not zero and looks like this. Remind that they numerate not 1, 2, 3 and so on, but by the not parity numbers like 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on. Without supersymmetry, we only bosonic sector, when we're considering only field function phi, we have the KdV with non-trivial and not usual non-linear term. This non-linear term is not only non-linear, but also in not local. This restricts our possible hydrodynamic application, but I think it's maybe more interesting than the classical one. Conservation value is invariant respect to time variables because time derivative of this one equals to zero. Okay. Momentum and energy also could be considered integral like this one and like this one is invariant respect to time. Not only soliton, but also noidal waves could be generalized to the case when p equals to one and p equals to zero. All intermediate cases when pi equal to a fractional value 0.1, 0.3, 0.5, and 0.9 presented on this picture. And really we have deformation of classical solution of noidal wave to to not symmetric, to deformed noidal wave, and in the next limit case we obtain the just derivative of noidal wave. Derivative means the function like this when pi equals zero. Okay. Deformation of soliton looks like this. We have when we pi equals to one, soliton looks like this. When we pi equals to zero, we have derivative of the soliton and solid curve like this. And also all intermediate deformations of classical soliton could be considered. In this point, I would like to say that if you obtain the not symmetric soliton, one of the possible to explain this phenomena is to introduce some non-localities, because it follows from this approach. Okay. One more. This is just a few sketch. I some time ago I thought about changing the dispersion relation, not to the from this one to expression like this one, and also it's possible to introduce the generalization of KdV non-local by the changing the third term by the fractional non-local operator. But advantage of this approach is that we have usual classical non-linear term, second non-linear term. But the price of this modification of this advantage is that we have the dispersion relation, which differs from the classical one. But just, this is just only mentioned. From my point of view, very interesting would be to obtain the generalization when the two commutation of two supersymmetric generalization looks like this, where here we have not the integer of first order space derivative, but fractional one with order of fractality pi, which could be fractional. Variety of the population models. The main idea of this section is that even in the simplest cases, we have a quite difference possibility to explain the observed phenomena in with some interesting aspects. No, just look to go to the examples. Malthus system is maybe a simplest evolutionary system which could be considered. This is just exponential growth. It could be generalized in the case when the rate growth rate coefficient R is not constant. Here is a constant, but it's possible to generalize when growth rate coefficient depends on the time. And in this case, we have solution in this form where R on T is integral of growth rate coefficient respect to time. What happens in the fractional generalization of Malthus law? In other words, we would like to consider an evolutionary equation when time derivative substitute by time derivative respect to the not integer order alpha. In the beginning with constant coefficient R, we obtain the solution like this. Here is special function, which has a special name, Mittag-Leffler, so-called Mittag-Leffler function. In if this function could be introduced like this one, like Syria. But solution depends not only that, but depends on a growth rate coefficient and T in power alpha. We can draw the behavior of this solution, and the difference is the not so fast growth like classical exponent. If alpha changes from 0 to 1, we have the growth not so fast like exponential. This is also signal to all experimental, to biological and medical and so on specialists, that if you obtain the growth, if you expect the exponential growth, but you obtain the growth little bit later, not so fast, please use this approach. Maybe you deal with the fractional generalization of evolutionary system. Maybe I have mentioned that fractional derivative is delicate aspect, and there are few of them, not unique fractional derivative. There is Samriman Liouville, Caputo, and mentioned Marchaux. The derivation is very not so difficult. Just we start from Fubini theorem for n times of integral, and after that applicate the Cauchy formula and obtain the fractional generalization. Gamma is Euler gamma function, which generalizes the factorial function at all. Before I said that alpha or p or pi runs from zero to unity, but it could be possible to generalize these operators for any real value alpha, and just separate the integer part or fractional part of the real value, and we can generalize the Riemann-Liouville, for instance, derivative to the fractional for any alpha more than zero. The sufficient, it's maybe interesting from mathematical point of view, sufficient condition for existence of fractional derivative is belonging to the class LP on R. Okay. Caputo derivative is essential because this doesn't change the asymptotic of functions, and we don't appear any problems with bordering condition, because constant fractional derivative of the constant function is not constant function and not zero, is a function like x in power minus alpha, but it's not so comfortable for application. And Caputo some time ago proposed the let we first calculate the usual derivative, and after that the acting by integral operator with some not singular kernel but not integer with not integer power. Such kind of generalization has some advantages for application. Just a short derivative the solution of fractional generalization of Malthusian's growth. It looks like this. We can Laplace transform of right-hand side looks like this initial solution. And after that, we can make inverse transform and obtain the solution in through the Mittag-Leffler function. Difference, yes. Not so far growth. I have mentioned about this, but I cannot show the picture of that. Application of course it's possible in biology and medicine and ecology and so on and so on. The next generalization is Delay system. In general, this extremely simple evolutionary system, time tau is time constant and time of delay, requires the numerical methods, and we have to use this method, but. Sometime we have some solution which has an analytical form. For instance, sinus function also is a solution of this system because substitution of this function in evolutionary equation obtain that when alpha and tau equals to pi or half of pi plus minus 2 pi n also obey the evolutionary equation, and we have the diagram alpha and tau dependence when we have infinite number of hyperbolic curves with difference number n. And all of them also belongs to the exact solution of the evolutionary system. But here I would like to stress that introducing to Delay qualitatively differences the solution of this simplest evolutionary equation. Not exponential growth, but finite periodical solution. Qualitatively, we have the huge difference between these two solutions. this simple, this consideration is and solution well known. It's not mine result, but this is it's possible to considering the fractional generalization. It's interesting because due to the property of a fractional derivative, the fractional derivative of the sinus. In the veil sense, when the we integral operator acting from minus infinity, derivative fractional derivative of sinus equals to the same sinus but with shifted argument, and shifting is alpha pi one half of alpha pi. When alpha equals to unity, we have half pi and obtain the cosinus, so the classical relation between sinus and cosinus. This one generalization of the simplest evolutionary equation, this harvesting system, when we, for instance, fishing with constant growth, for instance, time 10 fishes for months, every month. The solution became this classical results, it's not mine. Solution became behavior of solution depends on the initial value, because when initial value more than critical one pi zero, we have infinite growth of population. And in the opposite case, when initial condition less than critical value, we have the decreasing the population number, and we have the time of death, time when populations disappear. This is possible to estimate this time exactly, and when this ratio is much there, just propose a simple relation. It's possible to generalize the multi system with not constant growth rates of growth and not constant harvesting. In this case, we have introduced two functions, R and H, and in the general solution looks like this. T0 is initial time, P pi 0 is initial population volume. Okay, a few words about the Verhulst system. Verhulst system, this is also a classical result, obtained many years ago. Depends on initial conditions when we have only finite growth or decreasing in finite decreasing from initial conditions. Also, it's interesting that we can considering and obtain the generalization of this simple model when capacity is not constant. In this case, the solution also has analytical form and looks like this. We can generalize the situation when the growth coefficient also is not constant and depends on time variable. And this also, we have analytical solution, and this solution looks like this. What happened if we considering the fractional generalization? It's possible, and there are a few papers my colleagues that in this case solution could be expressed through the series of Mittag-Leffler function, which depend on the not just time variable, but time variable in power alpha with some special coefficients. Okay. Here is figure of the which show difference between the growth of solution for a difference value of fractional order alpha, and reflects the difference, the main idea that a fractional taking into account the fractional possibility of the evolutionary operator, we obtain the different kind of speed of the growth of the function in general. Okay, it's very, this is just illustration that it's very important to know the errors of parameters of any models, because if growth of rate we know with accuracy of 10%, in this case the possible field of the solution is huge, not huge, but it's not one curve, but it's just becomes area. And if you have a, if this person increase, this area also increase. This is just very simple, but it's important. Also, there is a Delay Verhuell system, systems like this one, but they have not, I don't know any analytical solution of system like this, and we can also only apply the numerical methods. And behavior in general case, you can see this not not periodical, not regular, not monotonic, and just very complicated. Okay, Delay. It's surprise that some Verhuell system with harvesting constant and not constant also admit the analytical solution. And here I have two expressions. With harvesting means that there are not two solutions like second and third, but also and first section, first region, when initial population belongs to this area, we have the time of death. In other words, we have the situation when population is decreasing. If the capacity or population growth is not constant, we can not one curve, but we can family of the curves, and it's possible to show the or area of growth from minimum to maximum, and all possible situation could be appear in this situation. The most general case when growth rate R and capacity and harvesting coefficient depends on T, this system also admits the analytical solution. Solution looks like this. Okay. Sorry. Not only Malthusian's growth and not only Verhuell's equation, but we have a number of more complicated and more interesting evolutionary system, and one of them is generalized Richardson equation. When second term in the brackets in power n, no, in the beginning n was integer number, but really it's could be not integer but in fractional one. Solution of this system also admit analytical form, and here is the result of this approach. With capacity, and capacity not constant, also we have the additional term here. The next generalization we can consider in the in this way, Gompertz system with harvesting, or maybe delay, or maybe fractional, and so on. And at least the last. I briefly see the time is my finishing. Analytical solution of evolutionary equations expressed in terms of a Lyapunov function. The main idea is very simple. Look, please. Historically, we have the experimental situation, the group of Novitsky, Vitaly, and co-authors studied the electroporation phenomena where, and they investigate the tumor growth. They have experimental results like this one. Square dots and the circle dots is here, but in advance we don't know the evolutionary equation. We don't know the behavior of this experimental data. In this case, we have to consider a lot of possible evolutionary systems and choose one of them which the best for the situation. This is a nice our results that we can use one of the evolutionary system and apply to experimental data. Experimental data is here, mathematical tumors growth, okay. Exponential, some of them we can consider before. This is a very simple, but maybe not so wide known generalization of Malthusian's growth when volume of the population depends not only in the power one, but in the power, you know, one for plus alpha. This is so-called hyperbolic type of solutions when solution is hyperbole like this. First time this law was introduced in 1975 to explain the demographic situation on the Earth. Okay. Logistic, I have mentioned about this. Richards, a little bit, yes, also. Gompertz, a special model for the tumor growth was proposed by Gompertz many years ago. It has some special kind and special solution. Originally, it proposed that the velocity of the growth depends on the like time exponential function, but it's not autonomous form. The autonomous form looks like this. Bertalanffy also some time ago introduced the equation like this one. To explain the fissuring problem in the world, and a solution like this, Bloomberg's model in some case we can generalize we can consider this model like generalization of Verhulst model. Logistic, yes, and generalized logistic growth, according to Solaris, we have the model of the growth like this one. And now the surprise is that the evolutionary equation of this form, after they change the variables, we have to introduce not volume on dependence volume on the time t, but t on the volume, and just introduce the inverse function. Inverse equation of motion looks like this one. V becomes an independent variable, but the bonus is that solution of this equation could be expressed through the Euler generalized beta function. generalized means this depends not only two variables A and B, but on four variables. Four variables, and I have some explanation later, but here I would like to show the table when we have one approach to the list of very famous and very well-known models, and all of them we can consider from one point of view, from point of view of generalized logistic growth model, this one, and all of them admits the analytical solution. The difference appear only by the value of coefficients alpha, beta, and gamma. There is three kind of coefficients. Dependence on value of these coefficients, we obtain the different evolutionary problem. I see the time is over, and thank you for your attention. I have to omit the beta function properties, and thank you again.
Thank you. Do you have any questions?
Maybe I have one question, if possible.
Okay.
So, hello. It was a very nice presentation. I have a question about, because actually I have to admit you have been the first person I learned about fractional derivatives. It was like 2 or 4 years ago, I remember. And then I even passed this knowledge to students. But the question is, what is the most important system from physics, known from physics or technical science, where fractional derivatives are needed? Because I don't think the fractional derivatives are something that natural. I would say x at time plus delta t minus x from at time t over dt is natural thing, is subtraction and division. So in a sense, fractional derivatives are very sophisticated conceptually. So what is the preliminary physical system I should refer to when I want to understand its essence?
No, look, please. There are some physical, different physical areas when fractional calculus could be applied. First of all, we have the fractal science, and when you considering the moving the particle on the fractal set, you have to change a classical derivative to the you have to generalize some kind of classical derivative, because in you have no derivative in classical sense on the fractal set. I think you agree with this point.
I can grasp this.
Fractional Koch snowflake has no derivative in any point.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Classical derivative, but his this snow curve has a fractional derivative in any point after the generalization of classical derivative. The next one is so-called Brownian motion, stochastic processes, and so on, so on. When you have the processes with memory, so-called not Markovian, the best way, at least now we have only this approach. You have to introduce some generalized system with which account the memory of the processes. In this way, the fractional derivative also helps us to solve mathematical problems. You are right, and I mentioned in my contribution that the concept of fractional derivative is delicate, and there are not one, but there are a lot of them. We can introduce fractional derivative, for instance, especially for your analyzed system. But if you can prove that it's necessary, after that you have a bonus like a solution, maybe exact solution, and you have an instrument which allows to analyze the system.
We have to finish.
Okay. Really, you know, just last sentence. A lot of this is nice cooperation between mathematicians and physicians. One of them deals with fractional calculus, pure mathematics, and other one deals with physical phenomena and trying to find new physical results.